control. Flight control.
Request refueling. Request rearming.
Copy. Refueling complete. Rearming complete.
Remove the wheel chocks.
Copy. Wheel chocks are now removed.
Enfield 1, taxi to Cat 2. clear as travel. Enfield 1, 7 miles departing.
Magic 1-1. In field 1-1. Request bogey dope. Magic 1-1. In field 1-1. Request bogey dope.
In field 1-1. Magic 1-1. Clean. Field 1-1, Magic 1-1, Bra 153460 at 20,000 hot. Enfield 1-1, Magic 1-1, Bra 188460 at 20,000 hot. Field 1-1, Magic 1-1, Bra 188450 at 27,000 hot. Enfield 1-1, Magic 1-1, Bra 154445 at 29,000 hot.
Thank you.
So I got hit by one, I did get them both in the end. Okay, let's climb up to 20,000 and we'll go tank and recover. Turn on, clear, 20 x-ray, to end, go, and go right ahead, and okay, switch that to HSI, and tack on, go, he's 83 miles away, oh, okay. SU-30 has just decided to respawn.
Enfield 1-1, Magic 1-1, Bra 196, 445 at 20,000 hot. Enfield 1-1, Magic 1-1, Bra 212, 435 at 20,000 hot.
Bingo.
Magic 1-1. In field 1-1. Request bogey dope.
Enfield 1-1, Magic 1-1, Bra 159, 445, at 20,000, flanking.
These guys. Disappear shortly. Yeah, there goes one. So our next engagement, I know I'm going to get hit by their Fox 3s, nothing I can do about that. I've only got one Fox 2 and my gun. I've got 6,700 pounds of fuel, the tank is 92 miles away.
Enfield 1-1, Magic 1-1, Bra 130-470, at 20,000, flanking.
So what I'm going to do is... it's going to come 90 degrees
on. Enfield 1-1, Magic 1-1, Bra 201-450, at 20,000, hot. Enfield 1-1, Magic 1-1, Bra 201-445, at 20,000, hot. Enfield 1-1, Magic 1-1, Bra 125-460, at 20,000, hot.
125-460. So that's that one. And he's 34 miles closing. There we go. So he's closing very fast. Right, channel on. Still got eyes on him. On here. Closing fast. Fox 2. Splash. Okay. Swing down. Relax.
Magic 1-1. Infield 1-1. Request bogey dope.
Enfield 1-1. Magic 1-1. Clean.
It's not clean. I've got... So, I know this guy.
Magic 1-1, Enfield 1-1, request bogey dope.
Enfield 1-1, Magic 1-1, clean.
I'm gonna be clean, I've got a lock on. Thank you. yet. I've got nothing left. Two-circle fight, but I'm in with a SU-34.
User joined your channel.
Yep. Bubsy, 1 second. Hey Bubsy, how you doing?
Alright mate, yourself?
Not too bad. I was just out in the range, doing a bit of BVR.
That's the spirit. Apart from that, you're on it.
Yeah, not too bad. Anything going on tonight?
No, I don't think so.
Yeah, I'm just...
I've been missing all week. I've been at York, sort of, a few days.
Any good?
Yep, it's alright.
Had fun?
Yeah. You weren't too busy. Christmas market was nice and steady.
Excellent.
Went out to a nice meal at Italian restaurant and it was alright.
Wonder bubbly.
I'm not a big traveller.
No.
Not anymore anyway.
Now you've done your fair share of travelling.
Well, strange really. My missus likes to get away. But I get bloody homesick, you know what I mean? I must be getting old and fucking boring.
Nah, you do your own thing, mate.
Yeah, that's it.
Right, I'm gonna go and tank now. Why don't you come join me? I'm on the server.
Alright. Hang on a second.
Just about to tank up. We could do some formation flying if you like.
Go on, I'll catch you. Stand by one. You on Rafair?
Roger that.
And SRS.
Roger that. I'm on the 41 squadron.
Got that.
Proceed to
Delivery contact at 20,000 at 300.
contact.
Cleared contact.
Oops.
Return pre-contact.
It was a bit silly of me, but there you are.
Contact. Bang.
There we go. Nice.
You're
and steady.
Taking fuel.
Okay.
Return pre-contact.
Oops.
Contact. You're taking fuel.
Keep that in the right hand, top right hand corner of the HUD. Be fine. Fuel page up so I could see and monitor my fuel status. Roger, 2. One's with the tanker. Texaco.
2, Roger. What's the altitude?
21,000.
21,000, Roger.
Go Takan 20 X-ray air to air, you'll find me because I'm with the tanker at the moment.
Transfer complete. Disconnect.
Disconnect. Tracking pro.
2-1 visual at 55 seconds.
Roger. Two visual on one. Sorry, one visual on two, I should say. One visual on two.
What's the tanky yoke? What frequency?
It's Texaco and it's I believe 251.1.
251.1.
Roger that. It should be box 2 stud 1.
Texaco 1-1, in field 2-1, request rejoin.
Infield 2-1, Texaco 1-1, proceed to pre-contact at 20,000, at 300.
Ready, pre-contact.
Cleared contact. Texaco 1-1, in field 1-1, request rejoin.
In field 1-1, Texaco 1-1, proceed to pre-contact at 20,000, at 300.
Ready, pre-contact.
Cleared contact.
Disconnecting. One's coming right.
Two.
One's coming left. 1 descending to 1,000 feet.
Altitude.
User entered your channel.
Hello. Hey, 8. 8.
We're on there, Yoke.
Sorry, buddy. I switched on the autopilot and it just decided to do a wobbly on me.
Nearly did a wobbly on me.
Sorry about that.
Okay. Can you hear me now?
Yeah, gotcha, buddy.
I had a really weird start up there. I only had an image in one quarter of my screen and had to reboot and all sorts.
Oh god.
What are you up to?
Just doing some formation flying. Me and Bob. Okay,
thanks.
Welcome to join us.
I'm going to go and have another go at that BVR thing.
Roger that.
I've almost got all my controls sussed now.
Brilliant.
Switching you.
Roger. One to two. One to two.
Two. Oh.
Bob, you read me? Bob, do you read me?
Yeah, go ahead, yo.
I was going to do a loop.
On you.
Ready?
Yep.
Okay. Well, I'm going to climb to about 2,000 feet and then we'll do the loop. Here we go. Leveling out. Increasing to 520 knots. Okay, and conducting the loop in 3, 2, 1, go.
pull was a bit slow, Yoke.
Roger. Increasing the pull. Disengaging the burner.
Two. Let me come back, you know. We'll try again. Pull a bit harder, Yoke. About 4G, 4.5G.
Roger that.
Pull straight into it.
Copy that.
Just give me a shout when you go.
Roger. Climbing back up to 2,000.
Too safe speed.
Slowing to 520 knots. Now when you're ready. Roger, okay. And conducting the loop in 3, 2, 1, go. Burner, go. How was that? Coming right, 20 degrees, climbing back up to 2,000.
Next time, pull harder.
Roger that.
Ready when you are.
I'm just climbing back up to 2,000 one second. Increasing to 500 knots.
No higher than 10.
Sorry, mate?
No higher than 10.
10,000?
At the top.
Roger, okay. Okay, here we go. Executing in 3, 2, 1, go. Burner, go.
Pull, Yoke, pull.
Burner off.
Altitude.
Better.
It's lack of practice on my part, Yoga. I haven't flown this for ages.
And
it's a perishable skill, like we know.
I know.
One more go and then pull harder. When I say pull, pull.
Roger that.
Ready, I'm going to come in really close, so I might bump you. Stand by. The closer I get, the better. On Ewing. When you're ready.
3, 2, 1, go. Burn up.
Do you want to have a go on me?
Altitude.
Roger that.
Cheers, the lead.
Roger. Say your speed, Bob.
420.
Roger that. Coming up on your right hand side.
Stand by steady, 180 left. 180 left. Go.
2.
Straighten it up.
Bob, is your tank empty?
Bingo. Bingo.
Bob, is your tank empty?
Springfield 1 departing Katahdin. Airspace is clear.
I'm going to ditch my tank, Yoga. I've got a £2,200.
What, in the tank?
Yeah. And I've only got... I'm not using the tank. I'm using the main fuel for some reason.
Check your refueling your fuel switches. Just below the throttle. You haven't inadvertently switched the... tank off, have you?
That looks alright. I'm going to ditch the tank anyway.
Roger.
We've obviously got two different drag rates.
Roger.
Has it gone?
Roger.
I'm out of your way and away from Kuatsi now.
Thanks, Ed. Let me know how you got on with the BVR.
Yeah, well, I did okay last time. Killed one on the way in and then the other in a dogfight, but I'm trying to get it so that I don't have to get into a dogfight.
Yeah. You need to drag them one way or the other. That'll stop them coming from two different directions.
Yeah, I see what you mean. Kind of force their hand.
That's it.
Switch sides, yo.
Roger, switching sides.
Nice. Stand by 45 left. 45 left. Go. Arrow right.
Two.
Altitude. Altitude.
Thank you.
34, 10 knots.
Two.
Standby loop. I'll pull quite tightly, Yoke, and I'll accelerate at the same time.
Roger.
But I'll try and stay below 10, 12,000 feet. Keep it fairly tight.
Roger.
Loop in 3, 2, 1. Pull in. I feel like.
Yeah, not too bad.
I think you're better, Yo, at 350 entry, 380, there or thereabouts, and then you can accelerate, push through the, just at the top, begin to bring the burner in to get you over the top, and then come back out again. So it's not a significant increase in speed. Or loss.
Okay, well, you dictate it, so I'll follow you.
Okay, 420, I'll slow down to 420. 420.
Two.
We're at 3,500 feet, let's see if we can't exit somewhere like that. 440. 430. 420. One set. Pulling in 3. 2, 1, go. Any better?
Yeah, kept you in my left-hand quarter, so didn't lose
right,
sight.
Come closer, come as close as you can, Yoke. Get stable, tell me when you're stable. Pick a reference that you can work off, but stay tight if you possibly can. You might find it's easier to stay tight once you're in tight, stop in tight. Slow to 420.
Okay, one is set.
420 at 2,000 feet. Stand by. 1, 2, 3, go. Coming off the throttle.
Altitude.
Any better?
Yeah, it was tighter. So yeah, that was good. I guess having a look at tack view would be a good idea.
Yeah,
you can check
more,
it afterwards.
Yeah?
Do one more, yeah. One more is good, yeah. And then
I'll
we'll
drop
do
back to four. Sorry, go ahead.
I was going to say we'll do a formation landing.
Yeah, yeah. I'll get back to 400. And I'll drop down to 1500. So we're at 400 knots, 1600 feet. One set.
Two set.
Three, two, one. Pull. Any better?
Yeah, not too bad, not too bad. I didn't lose sight of you, but I think I stretched a little bit. But that'll come with practice. Like you say, it's a perishable skill. Last
Absolutely.
Time I did this, or we did this, was about a year ago.
Yeah, and we were a lot better then.
We were. I got the videos of them.
Right, we did
we did a seven ship.
Yeah. I used to enjoy that, yeah. I thought it was really good fun when there was Will leading and there was, what, there was Russ, me, you, Jason.
We'll try and do it again. Get Aid to lead us next time.
Where's Aid gone? Is he still fighting?
Yeah, he's up in the BVR.
Yeah, I'm just engaging now.
Okay, Bob, you've taken us back, and we'll do a formation landing. You lead.
Do Roger, stand by. Right turn.
Two. My gun is 44 X-ray.
Yeah, I'm selecting 44 X-ray, but I'm not. That's it, we're. So you want straight in, not break?
Yep. like Will used to do for us.
Got you. Reducing 420.
Two. Make sure you switch anti-skid on.
Two got that.
Two good kills, clear radar, departing the BVR.
Well done, Aid.
I'm going to head for the boat.
Reducing 350.
Two.
Maintain 2,500. Reduce 280. Stand by gear and flaps at 250. Flaps and gear, go. Steady at 150. Stay left of centre, yo.
Two.
low. Fuel low.
I didn't feel too bad.
That was great.
We don't practice enough, Yo. That's how it's got.
I didn't think that was too bad, mate. Under the circumstances.
Yeah.
There's an awful lot of stuff to practice when you think about it.
There is, Aid. We're not flying enough.
That's right. You need to fly every night of the bloody week if you want to stay in practice with everything.
At least three or four nights.
God, yeah. I got almost all the way to the BVR range because I've had a couple of days off due to a panic order come in, and I forgot to turn my IFF on. I turned it on in time. But stuff disappears out of your routine if you don't do it often enough, doesn't it?
Yeah.
Definitely.
I've got two MFDs up and running, you know.
Yeah, I heard you say, Bob. Sounds bloody marvellous.
Yeah, and I've also now got the scratch pad. I've finally done it. It took me months and months and fucking months. And I've finally got it to work, the scratch pad at the front. So now what I can input everything right in front of me on the UFC, not the instrument UFC, the one I've made.
Yeah.
And the only problem is my eyes now are habitually going to the places where they usually go and not fucking taking advantage of what the fucking lot is made.
It takes a while to settle into it. I'm still fighting this new throttle, Bob. I've had it, 4 weeks? And I'm still bolting it up. But I've had 3 years, no, more than that, I've had 4 or 5 years on Warthog, so getting me left hand to learn the new buttons.
Which one did you get, Aid?
It's one of those Verpil.
Is that a Hornet?
No, it's not. I bought it second hand off of Chris, funny enough.
Right, okay.
I forget what the model is, but it's got something like 54 buttons on it.
Wow.
So I can map everything now, because I'm in VR, I can map absolutely bloody everything. And that's only using one of 5 modes.
Wow.
So if I get too clever with it, I could use another mode, say an air-to-air mode, and alter all the switches. But my brain can't cope with what it's got.
Yeah, I was thinking about getting the wing one, which is a replica of the F-18.
Yeah, I was seriously looking at that as well, but I got a 3080 Ti instead.
Oh, fair enough.
You got what, Aid?
New graphics card, 3080 Ti.
Nice.
And I've now got everything to maximum in VR, and I'm only down to 45 frames per second.
Nice.
Oh, it's real now. It's crystal. It's stunning.
Nice.
So it was worth the loss of the win-win for that, I think.
I got myself a 3080 normal one, just for my birthday, which was back in October.
Yeah, I remember. I don't know what the difference is between the Ti, but it's...
You've got more memory on board.
Right, yeah, it's 12 gig. It's only 1% down, 2% down on a 3090. Performance.
Nice.
Because the 3090's got 24 gig of memory on board or something.
Yeah, no, it's ridiculous. Mine's got 8 gig, I think.
Right.
Did you have any problem getting hold of it, Aid?
Oh, I was searching for nearly a year. And then eventually it popped up and it was 1,400 euros.
Oh, that's good.
All I could think. Yeah, brace, thank you. Oh,
in the UK or France?
No, in France. But it came in packaging with nothing. There weren't cables, nothing in it. And there was a label on it saying this is no good for crypto mining.
Wonderful.
So I'm assuming the crypto miners weren't interested in it, so nobody would pay the money for it. So he put it up at 1,400 and I bit his hand off. I think he's still picking his fingers up off the floor.
Yeah, you installed it fine, no problems at all.
I installed it, did the driver. Well, the driver was done by NVIDIA's automatic thingy.
Yeah, yeah.
And I switched it all back on and had 120 frames a second. So I then started to push everything up as far as I dared and watched the frame rate come down. That was the only adjustment I did. And I ended up with everything set to max with 4x MSAA. So all the straight lines are lovely and straight. And the lowest I could get it was 45 frames a second, so I've left it there.
Nice.
I have to say I'm over the moon.
Oh, well, it's Christmas.
That's what I thought, Bob. And funny enough, this month I've made 6 knives, so that's virtually the cost of the graphics card paid for.
Nice. Do you export to the UK as well, then?
I'm on hold at the moment until they sort out the rules for sending weapons since Brexit.
Oh, right, okay.
While you were part of Europe, I could legally send them, but I have to include a legal notice of the laws in Britain so that you know what you can and can't do with it.
Right.
Because if you go into a town, you're only allowed a 10 centimetre folder with a non-locking blade. However, if you're out walking in the countryside, mountains, or you're a ghillie, a hunter or something like that, you can have anything you want, basically. It's just being reasonable in the eyes of the law.
Right.
And if you do carry one of mine into town, it really must be locked in your glove box, otherwise the police won't be happy with you.